The sky above her was scattered with twinkling stars, and so she decided to create a star trail to frame the fireflies. Yes, बचपन में जब हमसे कोई पूछता था कि आप बड़े होकर क्या बनिएगा, तो ज्यादातर लोगों का जवाब होता है डॉक्टर, इंजीनियर, लॉयर या फिर ऐसे ही कुछ. लेकिन जैसे जैसे हम बड़े होते हैं, वी डिस्कवर आर ओन पैशंस, वी डिस्कवर आर लाइक्स, वी डिस्कवर आर सेल्फ फॉर दैट मैटर. हमें क्या पसंद है, हमें क्या ना पसंद है. और ऐसा ही कुछ किया हमारी आज की प्यारी सी गेस्ट ने. यस, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऐश्वर्या श्रीधर, हु इज आवर गेस्ट ऑन टुडेज शो. शी इज अ यंग टैलेंटेड वाइवेशियस 23 ईयर ओल्ड गर्ल हु इज डेफिनेटली द इन्फ्लुएंसर दैट वी ऑल आर लुकिंग आउट फॉर. Wildlife photographer and filmmaker. Her grit and determination and a fearless spirit made all her dreams come true. So before I welcome her on the show, please subscribe to our channel and join our community. Hello Aishwarya, welcome to Women Influencers Talk Show. The first question that I'm going to ask you is that being so young, how do you feel like making such a difference?
I feel very humbled that I got an opportunity to make a difference.
Wonderful. Aishwarya, you are not just an award-winning filmmaker, presenter and photographer, but also someone who loves wilderness. So as a kid, were you always drawn towards jungle stories and wildlife?
Yes, absolutely. I have grown up on the books of Jim Corbett and Kenneth Anderson. So from a very early age, I have been in love with wildlife. Then again, I am from Panvel. So Panvel was a very green place when I first moved into this lovely city. So it wasn't a city. It was more of a tiny village when we first came here. And I used to see fireflies in my balcony. I used to, from my house garden, see quails and see partridges and also see wild boars roaming on the streets just outside my house. So my entire childhood was spent in close connection with Mother Nature, and somehow there was a bond that was more like a mother-child bond that I had with nature. So I don't know why, but for some bizarre reason, I felt that if I talk to my plants in the garden, they'll give me better flowers. So I remember when I was like after homework, after school, I used to come back and I used to spend time talking to the plants in my garden, thinking that, you know, they're going to give me brighter and more colorful flowers. So yes, that love for nature has always been there.
That's awesome and such a beautiful past. Aishwarya, you were born in Mumbai and almost completed your entire studies in India. But later on, you went on to become the world topper in business studies paper at Cambridge International Examination. So from being a business studies topper to now being a filmmaker and a photographer, what was the decision-making moment?
So I've always been a studious child, right from school, even during college days. But at the same time, I have been observing the human impact on our environment. For example, the wetlands around my home and around the local city where I used to go birding have all completely disappeared. And today, very few pockets of these marshes remain, which I used to bird earlier. So when I was noticing the way our entire economy and our ecology was shaping, somewhere I felt that these mute creatures do not have a voice. And there are enough CAs and MBAs and engineers and doctors out there, but very few people who are the voice for our planet. And I really loved wildlife. I loved being outdoors. And if given a chance, if I had to choose between my textbooks in classroom and probably sitting in a jungle and watching a tiger, I would any day pick sitting in a jungle. So I felt that maybe I wasn't quite suited for a typical 9-to-5 academic job, But instead, I wanted to really help Mother Nature, be a part and make a difference in the world. So I felt that, yeah, I could probably be the voice for these creatures, and that's why I completely shifted gears and pursued mass media after my 12th for my graduation.
Now that's what we call clarity of vision and working towards your goal. Very, very inspiring, Aishwarya. Now during this COVID-19 and especially during the lockdown, you presented and directed a 8-part digital series for WWF India, which inculcates love for wildlife in children through origami. That's commendable. So how was the response like?
The response was fantastic. I received a lot of kids, you know, messages from children across India and even from abroad who sent me their cute origami pieces that they had made of elephants and rhinos, and I was so happy, and I felt really glad that I did this series along with WWF India for these children, because the lockdown was really a tough time for everyone, and I'm sure the kids out there must have been really bored, because children are normally the type, you know, to go out and play, and they couldn't meet their friends, no school. So that time was really difficult, especially for them, more so. So I was really wanting to do something, and I felt that the origami would have entertained them, at the same time also inculcated that love for nature within them.
Sure, why not? I'm really glad to hear such innovative ideas that you think of to promote sensitivity towards nature and feel the power of it. So Aishwarya, how much importance is given to wildlife conservation in our country, and what steps need to be taken urgently to protect it?
I feel that wildlife conservation really needs to get more importance than what it is being given right now. I'm not saying that there is no importance given, there is, but it definitely needs to be more, because there is still this mentality that exists in our country that for development, we can clear forests. I mean, every other day there is some other news that a marsh or a wetland has been cleared for building a luxury apartment complex, or there is a notification that comes from a wildlife board which clear denotifies part of a protected area, for example in Uttarakhand, for expansion of an airport. I mean, these are not really needed at this time of the hour, because we are facing the sixth mass extinction, and extinction is permanent, so there's no reversal to this. We lose a species, we lose it forever, and over 1 million species are facing threat of going extinct permanently in the world. So I think it's high time that we wake up and we decide that we should not be trading our ecology for our economy. I know this whole mentality, like many people when they think of conservationists and environmentalists, they have this mental image, you know, that these people are against development. No, sorry, we're not. All we are trying to tell you is that you protect wildlife for a lasting development. It's not a man versus nature thing. Even I do understand, being a commerce student at some point in my life, that economy is important, GDP is essential for employment, for income generation, yes. But it shouldn't be so much the focus that we decide to ruin our own health. And we are seeing that very example right now when we are facing the pandemic. This whole issue of COVID-19 started in the wet markets of Wuhan because of illegal wildlife trade, because we took wildlife conservation and our planet for granted. So I think it's high time that we stop doing that and realize that for a healthy life and for our own survival, we need a healthy planet.
Absolutely. Very wise words coming from you, Aishwarya, and I can't agree more with you. Taking things for granted, and especially our health and our ecosystem, has landed us today in this pandemic, and that's such a shame. Aishwarya, you have also hosted shows like Earth to Humans. So why did you choose to host them?
So Nature for Future was in collaboration with Discovery Channel India and WWF India. Earth to Humans is a podcast by Wildlands Collective, which is an international organization. So these shows start a conversation around wildlife conservation. And to me, it gives me an opportunity to connect with people doing incredible work who are going out there and working every day to protect our ecosystem and our planet, and also to tell their stories of their struggles, their journey and their achievements out there to the world, so that everyone gets inspired by listening to these stories. So that's the reason I choose to host shows like these.
Aishwarya, all I can say is that you are a remarkable young soul who is doing every bit in your capacity to create awareness about wildlife, environment and the ecosystem, and it's just commendable what you're doing. You have been featured in prestigious magazines like BBC Wildlife, Guardian, Sanctuary Asia to name a few. You have also won many accolades like Sanctuary Asia Young Naturalist Award, and that too at the age of 15. Amazing. And also Princess Diana Award and many more. So how tough has it been for you to achieve all of this?
It has been a tough journey for me because all this was happening simultaneously along with my education. So I had to balance out studies, examinations, board exams and all of this on one side, and at the same time also pursue my passion and simultaneously a sort of a career in wildlife. So yeah, it was a pretty tough juggling both. And obviously, like the rest of the people, I've also faced challenges in terms of lack of funding or getting exposure for your work to go and put out your work to the right people. So yeah, these are the normal challenges that one faces in any field for that matter. And so at that point, I probably during my school days, I did miss out on hanging out with friends. And all my friends used to complain because you're either out there in the jungle or you're sitting at home and studying for exams. Well, I didn't have any free time. So yeah, that's one of the things.
Well, that's what we call valuing time and making the best use of what comes our way. And you have proved it right. Aishwarya, you have made us all so proud by being the first Indian woman to win the Wildlife Photographer of the Year award in 2020. That's just amazing. Now, please tell us something about it. And also, why did you choose Lights of Passion as your title?
Lights of Passion. Thank you. Thank you so much. So it's one of my favorite images. And the reason I named it Lights of Passion was because the whole image captures the fireflies and their bioluminescence under the starlit sky at Bhandardhara. So their courtship ritual basically includes them emitting out light to attract a suitable partner, and that's how their lovemaking is. So I felt the name aptly captures that behavior of these tiny creatures, and yeah, that's why I named it Lights of Passion. Because of their bioluminescence.
That's awesome and a very aptly named picture, I must say. Aishwarya, wildlife photography is still not seen as a full-time career in our country. What would you like to say about that?
Not just wildlife photography. In fact, any job that requires a girl to be outdoors for a considerable amount of time is not accepted in India. I mean, the notion of a proper lady doing a good job is only limited to a desk job at a company. So I think our mindset needs to be changed, and we should be more accepting that women can do and excel any job for that matter.
Absolutely. You are a torchbearer for so many people. Kudos to you. Aishwarya, during this journey of wildlife photography and filmmaking, I'm sure you must have come across many obstacles. So which one was the hardest to overcome?
Okay. So in terms of challenges, I would say there are many, but one of the toughest has been to get proper permissions from the government for filming, because when you approach a government for making a documentary on any wildlife in a national park, there is a host of conditions that come: don't do this, don't do that, you should do this, you should do that. It makes it very difficult for an independent filmmaker to tell the story they want to. So that's one of the hardest things, in fact, and I feel that I think we should make this whole process more easier, because that way a lot more people will be wanting to enter this field. And we have an incredible amount of wildlife in India. It's one of the most biodiverse ecosystems on the planet. So I think it's important that the Indian government also realizes that, and we should definitely simplify this process. because that's a very tough challenge to get the permissions out.
I second that, Aishwarya. Any kind of limitations and bondage, especially for a creative person, just adds to the ordeal of creating a masterpiece. And this should completely change. Now, as a woman, what kind of challenges did you face in your journey?
As a girl, one challenge is definitely finding proper sanitation facilities at jungle when you're out there in the field, because sometimes you're not in a proper national park which has good toilet facilities. So at that time it becomes a little difficult, especially when you're on periods and all that. But otherwise I haven't faced any other challenge just because of my gender. But there's definitely a societal mind block when it comes to, you know, accepting women in professions like wildlife photography. So that my relatives and my friends, they definitely do tell me that, you know, being in this profession, you won't get a good husband and you won't have a happy marital life. And I'm like, why? Because this is this very similar to any other job for that matter. So that mindset is what needs to be changed, because we need to be more accepting when it comes to letting women and girls choose their career as per their dream. So that is one big challenge that any woman out there would face.
So true. I mean, just look around ourselves. It's such a pity, such a shame, where on one side we are talking about women empowerment and women rights. On the other side, we are having so many prejudices, so many rules, so many regulations, so many bondages for women. I mean, I'm talking to all of you people, girls, boys, men, women, please wake up. Please look around. Let's make a safe, healthier place for each one of us. Let's make a beautiful world out there. And this pandemic has taught us so much. So if not now, then when? I'm sorry, I can go on and on. So let's come back to the reality and let's talk to Aishwarya. Aishwarya, my last question to you is that what are your thoughts about our initiative?
It's a lovely show and I'm so thankful to be a part of it. I feel that this show definitely helps connect women changemakers and women influencers from around the globe. And it provides a platform where we can network, we can socialize, we can get inspired looking at each other's work. And all the young girls out there who are watching this show, I'm pretty sure after watching the numerous episodes, they too would definitely get the courage and be inspired to follow their dream.
Thank you, Aishwarya, for coming on our show and sharing your experience and your journey. It was truly inspiring. Here, I would like to take a moment to thank all you beautiful people who are watching this show. Thank you for subscribing to our channel. Thank you for sharing its links. And thank you for showing all your support and love. You truly, truly are inspiring us. Thank you so much. A big thank you to all the people who participated in the contest in the last episode, and congratulations to the winners. Your gifts are coming your way. So till we meet next time again, take care, stay safe, and be happy.